Hello and welcome to Learning from Leaders. We are excited to have Karen of Boss Insights joining us for our weekly show on all things digital transformation and innovation. Karen, welcome to the show.
Hello, Lizbeth. I cannot imagine doing this with anyone other than you.
Oh, thank you.
Hello.
I feel the same. We met at LendIt, and yes, I have been so happy to be connected ever since.
Do we owe LendIt a thank you card and perhaps a bottle of wine? Is that what we're saying here?
We will tell Joy, their president over there. Yes, so for our audience, we are both members also of the Canadian Lenders Association, and we recently hosted a webinar on lending trends and predictions. So that was something exciting that we both did. And begin, I think I would just like you to introduce yourself to our audience and let us know also how you chose the name Boss Insights.
Hello, audience. So I'm Karen, and the first thing I want to say is that I'm one of you. I'm a former banker. I was working in commercial banking at RBC, and I found myself really frustrated because my job was to get loans approved, and I had to grow my book of business. And what that really meant to me was I got to deal with people running businesses, hundreds of them over the course of my stint there. But it was always a challenge to try and get those loans approved and even get the information required in order to do so. And I teamed up with somebody who'd been scaling technology his entire career, and he was working at Amazon. And he said, you know, the insights we have here, every business could use this, and I'm going to democratize it. This was back in 2013, way before anyone was talking this way. And in 2017, we set out to build a platform that could be adopted in 1 hour by lenders, banks, credit unions, and fintechs, so they could pre-qualify borrowers, so they could then decision borrowers and service them. And as we've gone through it, we've just added a whole bunch of features on top. The name Boss Insights, here's a little tea for everybody. It's an acronym. It stands for Back Office Software Systems. So the tea is we're all geeks, and all we live on is data and back office software, and we make that available to you in an hour.
I thought you were just the boss.
Oh, yeah. And when you're using our platform, you can kill the industry like a boss. There you go. So
perfect. I like it. Well, thank you for sharing a little bit about how you got started there. And so for our next question, if you could share a little bit about why you think it's important to focus on transforming financial services for your career and why you've dedicated your life to this.
Yeah, I see, when you think about it that way, it doesn't exactly, you wouldn't think, oh, that five-year-old there is going to grow up and then to transform financial services, because the five-year-old, I have some, right? And the five-year-old is actually thinking about other things. And for me, this isn't so much about transforming financial services. It is more about taking a look at the driver behind the economy, which is small and medium businesses and commercial businesses. That's what's keeping us all in business, and giving them what they need to move forward. And that can be true whether they're a business that has had every opportunity. It can be true whether they are a diverse or inclusive person owning a company who has been maybe pushed to the side because of how the traditional processes work. And because I was dealing with them, and because I myself am the child of an entrepreneur who was the child of an entrepreneur, it was in my blood to think, what about this business owner? What about their family? How do we actually make this work? The process we have in place is choking us. There's no question about it. CB Insights they basically had a mic drop moment at the end of Q4 last year. And they said, traditional lenders like banks, they were losing market share 1% every year until 2020. 9% was lost last year. And so I'm basically trying to make it possible to honor everything good that is entailed in a complete financial relationship and speed up that lending process so we can all go home happy.
Well, I think it's a great thing to dedicate your career towards. So next for our audience, as we all know, 2020 and 2021 has been quite a year. So what would you say you feel is most important right now in the lending world?
So if it was real estate and everyone says location, 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 in business lending, it's capital, capital, capital. And I think the proof of that is in the pudding. We see that businesses, if they can't get loans from their regular lenders, they'll go somewhere where they can get loans. So if you're a traditional lender, and you could be a private lender, you could be a credit union, you could be a bank, it doesn't matter. If you're a traditional lender, you are really at the mercy of the latest lending technology. And the reason is we've shown that you can make decisions 5 times faster, that you can take away 80% of the cost of servicing these loans when it comes to grabbing those documents. We just think, everybody in the industry that I'm working with, the common thread is we have to get these businesses back to doing business. We have to get them out of the business of speaking bank, speaking capital. That's not what they set out to do. And I think that's the biggest trend. So you'll see that there's a big divide between traditional lenders who want to adopt the latest in fintech and traditional lenders who want to stay the course, and they are operating quite differently. The first group is attracting the best-in-class fintechs and working with them, and they're acting as the relationship provider, but they're letting the fintechs do what they do best, which is user experience and quick decisioning and just a much more personalized approach to targeting businesses, whereas the traditionalists are wanting to grab financial statements whenever you require them and wanting to review them. What we try and communicate with anybody that we are lucky enough to be in a room with is that you don't have to decide between those two extremes. You can make it the gathering process faster and stick to traditional credit review. So it's not either or. Mm-hmm. It's really your choice.
That makes sense. I love it. thank you for sharing that with our audience. I think the next question we have for you is, Boss Insights has the widest and broadest breadth of APIs in the industry. So that's pretty impressive for real-time data in the lending industry. Can you break down for our audience why this is so important?
Sure. It goes back to what credit is about. If you're a business, and I've seen this now as somebody applying for a loan, as someone managing loans, and as someone selling to business lenders, the process is as follows. I need money. And then the lender says, great, I need information because I can't give you money without your information. If you have a small subsection of information, if it's just accounting only, you have limitations to that. And Boss Insights was not built to solve the problem of the day. It was built to give a complete view of a business to people who wanted to give capital to that business and to give transparency to the business who's asking for the money. So rather than just show financial statements, we show real-time revenue earning in our commerce category. We show accounting and financials in our accounting category. With our banking partners, we show the banking statements. We will show credit bureau reports. We will show sales information in our sales category, operations of the business, and it goes on and on and on. Why is this important? COVID gave us the real reason why this was important. In March of 2020, there was a new style of lending, and it was COVID-style funding, and it's called PPP, Paycheck Protection Program. So all of a sudden, an industry that as far back as anyone can remember was lending on the health of a business, meaning show me your numbers, did you earn more than you spent, started lending on how many employees you have. And if you only have one category, you can't process that loan request. But we did have that. So we did spin up a portal in 3 days, and we did show that we had 2 times as many applications accepted to forgive that loan as was the average.
So very impressive.
Yeah. So that's the real reason. It's, you know, and if I were to take it one level higher, it's because if you really want to serve the ecosystem, if you want to give them that personal experience that they're getting from, let's say, Amazon, you have to meet them where they are. You can't tell a business to adopt whatever technology you're giving them. You have to say, what are you using? What does your day-to-day look like? And measure them like that.
Yep, we completely agree with that here at Turnkey Lender. We are all about the customer experience and making everything with lending as easy as using Amazon.
Is this why we get along so well?
Yes, obviously. and so just a few more questions for our audience. So I was just curious what you're most excited about right now in the tech, lending, or financial industry.
I'm really excited that we're no longer having discussions where we're saying, I'm digitized. You know, it's almost like a t-shirt, I'm digitized. But the thing is, we all know that at the start of last year, everyone was ordering laptops, right? So we're all agreeing that we are at the start of this and we have a long way to go. Mm-hmm. The collaboration that we've seen with the lenders we're working with cannot be compared. I've heard CEOs of banks like Carver Bancorp on the phone with their business borrowers to make sure that they get their loans approved. We're working, CC Bank was very direct with us and honest that in 1 to 2 months using a platform, they got 2 to 3 years worth of leads. But the thing that was most inspiring to them was a quote from their customer saying that the loan saved their business. Mm. And the list goes on and on and on. And we are out there always looking for lenders to want to collaborate with us. Mm-hmm. What I mean by that is we're not just selling you a product that you turn on and you get what you get. And sorry, we don't have any ability to hear what you have to say about the market. That's not how we approach it. We are a very agile company. So we stand apart in the industry for two reasons. We have more data, but also we listen to you. If you want more features, more data sources, tax has been asked for a lot, come to us. We will make that possible. And that's the thing that's most exciting about right now. Lending models are changing. Mm-hmm. I know Turnkey Lender is facilitating a lot of that, actually. Mm-hmm. And we're just here to gather the client information so that you can almost read their mind for them. They don't know that they need an invoice factoring because their accounts receivable days are aging. Yep. But we can tell you that, and then you can approach them as a group and say, hey, hit a button. You're ready to go.
Mm-hmm. I love it. That's what we're seeing in the manufacturing industry all over. Digital transformation is, if you aren't, you know, doing it right now, you're not going to survive. So it's very important.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I think just two more questions for our audience. So what would you want to share for some good advice for someone who wanted to start out in the industry and saw you as a role model?
Gosh. Well, first, if you see me as a role model, don't put me too high. The thing about anyone starting a company is that you got to fail fast and you got to move forward. So, and we do that by listening. I think the one thing I would have wanted to do earlier, if I could do it over again, is more customer interviews. Try and get in front of as many. And the customer interview name is almost, it's the wrong name. You want to meet people in your target market and not think of them as a customer and just ask them what they've done to this point and what they want. And if you know that, if you have that under your belt, then you can create a product that everybody will want to see. And the other thing I would like to say is find people who will be real collaborators where 1 + 1 = 3. A collaboration is one where it works for you, it works for the other party. So often, that's not how it happens. And I think Turnkey Lender really shows that. They give so much to the ecosystem, so much to the industry. So those are the two pieces of advice that I'd want to give out there.
Thank you. Well, I love it. I agree. I'm looking forward to where our partnership goes together. And then I think anything else that we perhaps did not chat about that you would like to share with our audience today?
Yeah. You know, there's a new style of information that everybody's really excited about. So I wanted to chat about what we can see going forward. So traditional lending looks at financial statements when it's, let's say, over a certain amount and under. Both are basically telling you how much money a company has after they make their expenses. This is what lending always was. What we're hearing a lot about now is commerce. So with Square, with Stripe, with Shopify, with WooCommerce, there's a list of 15 or so that we integrate with. What you get is if you want to see the businesses that you're lending to, where they keep their capital outside of their bank, this is the way to do it, and it's verified. And I would say that this is going to be the hot category in 2021 to get access to. So if anyone's interested to learn more about what this information can do for you, how you can use it to help serve those customers, please let us know.
Well, thank you. I think commerce, that's a great way to wrap up. And if anyone wants to reach out to you, how should they get in touch?
We're on LinkedIn at Boss Insights, and you can also reach us at our website, bossinsights.com. We'd love to chat with you, hear what you have to say. And we also want to hear what you love about Turnkey Lender so we can pay it forward.
Yes. So,
thank you.
Sounds perfect. Well, thank you so much, Karen. I've enjoyed our chat, and thank you to our audience for listening.